Hello friends, welcome to our channel Brain Exploders, where we share all kinds of brain boosters, teasers, puzzles, riddles and stumping questions. Here is our previous question. A cube of side length 10 cm is placed on the ground in such a way that only one of its corner is touching the ground. Due to vertical rays of light, it casts a shadow on the ground. If its opposite corner is 15 cm above the ground, then find the area of the shadow. Here is the cube and some vertical rays of light are falling on it, due to which a shadow is forming on the ground. If its vertical height is 15 cm and side length of cube is 10 cm, then find the area of shadow. If you have not tried this question yet, you can pause the video for more time. So here is the solution. First, we will discuss the dielectric to solve this question, and after that we will prove it. So if side length of cube is A and vertical height is H, then area of shadow becomes AH. Now we will prove it. We will use two concepts in proving this. First, if a rod is kept with one of its end on origin and we rotate it about origin through an angle theta, then the new coordinates of its another end becomes a cos theta minus b sin theta comma a sin theta plus b cos theta. And second concept that we will use is here. Suppose this is an irregular surface with an area x, and about this axis we rotate it through an angle of theta, then it will look something like this, and this visible region will have an area x cos theta. And these two concepts we will use in our proving. Now suppose this is the cube and all its surfaces are perpendicular to the coordinate axis. Suppose this end is a by 2, because all the sides of cube are having the same length and we have supposed that it is a, so its opposite end becomes -a/2, -a/2, -a/2. Now if we rotate it about the z axis through an angle theta and about x axis through an angle phi, then it will look something like this. Now here we have to find the difference between z coordinates, which will help us in finding the vertical height. So first we will find the z coordinate of P dash. Suppose a random point is taken on the shape A, B, C, and if we rotate the shape through an angle of theta along z axis, then its z coordinates will not change and its x and y coordinates will change, and we get a cos theta minus b sin theta comma a sin theta plus b cos theta comma c. Now in second step, we have to rotate the shape through an angle of phi along x axis. In this situation, its x coordinates will not change and change will occur only in y and z coordinates. So we get these coordinates here. Since we have to deal only with the z coordinates, so we get z coordinates of P dash is equal to a/2 sin theta + a/2 cos theta times cos phi sin phi plus a/2 cos phi. If we take a/2 as common, then we get a/2 (sin theta sin phi) + cos theta sin phi + cos phi. And similarly, coordinates of Q dash are exactly the same with the minus sign. And distance between P dash and Q dash, the vertical height between P dash and Q dash is this: a sin theta sin phi plus cos theta sin phi plus cos phi. Now time to use our second concept. If we are looking at the cube exactly from one side, then only one surface will be visible to us with an area of a square centimeters. And if we rotate it through an angle of theta, then another surface which was not visible earlier will be slightly visible with an area a square sine theta, and the visible surface will become a square cos theta. Now we are rotating the cube along x-axis with an angle phi, so cube will be visible something like this. And with the same concept, we can say that the surface which was looking at first with an area of a square is now a square cos theta cos phi, and another surfaces are a square sine theta cos phi, a square sine phi. But that is not the shadow. The shadow will be the area which is looking exactly from the top, because only that portion of lights are blocked. So exactly from the top, the area looking will be a square, and then it is rotated via an angle theta. Now it will look something like this. Since in the side view, the surfaces are gaining an area a square cos theta and a square sine theta, but these are not visible in top view. But if we will rotate it by a 90 degree along x-axis, then the areas will be a square cos theta and a square sine theta. So we will deal with these areas, and if we rotate it via an angle phi, then we get areas a square cos phi, a square cos theta sine phi, and a square sine theta sine phi, and this is the area of shadow. We have earlier calculated the vertical height is a cos phi plus a sine theta sine phi plus a cos theta sine phi, and area of shadow is this. So if we take a as common, then we get area of shadow is equal to a times h, that is 150 square centimeters, and it is our solution. Let's move toward another question. Find the ratio of red and yellow region. Here we have a regular hexagon, and some measurements in this are given. We have to find the ratio of red and yellow region. Try this question and comment as the solution. And if you have any question like this, send us on the Gmail given in the description box. Don't forget to like and share our video, and for more such videos, subscribe to our channel Brain Exploders. Thanks for watching.